Okay. Now we go to forces and energy and subchapter 3.1, forces and motion. Yeah. Forces related with the motion, because forces sometimes we know that related with mass and acceleration. But now, before we continue our lesson, I think it will be better if we read this. And I need Mbak Nadia Salma. Mbak Nadia Salma, please read this one. Mbak Nadia?
Okay. In this topic, you will understand that is mean by balanced and unbalanced force. Describe the effect of balanced force and on motion. Describe the effect of unbalanced force on motion.
Okay, thank you so much, Mbak Nadia. So today we our aims, yeah, understand what is mean by balanced and unbalanced forces, yeah. Nanti kita akan bahas tentang gaya yang seimbang dan tidak seimbang, and then describe the effects of balanced forces on motion, effect of unbalanced, ya. Jadi kalau ada gaya yang balance seimbang dan unbalanced nggak seimbang, itu efeknya apa? Oke, kita lanjut aja. Ini sebenarnya ini what is the unit forces of force? Unitnya apa? Anyone knows the unit of force?
Newton.
Good. The unit of force is Newton. Who answered just now? Siapa yang menjawab tadi?
Zafira, Pak.
Zafira, ya. Okay, thank you, Mbak Zafira. How are forces shown on diagrams? Bagaimana gaya itu bisa ditunjukkan dalam gambar? Di sini diagram, maksudnya ya gambarnya bagaimana force itu. Ya, force itu biasanya kayak gini ya. Sometimes we know from the books that there is a box here and then someone give force, maybe push the box, and then there is an arrow. Jadi ada anak panah. Ini force. Nah, biasanya ditunjukkan kayak begini ya. The diagram of force. Of force, ya. And the direction of the arrow show to us the direction of the movement. Jadi kalau arah dari anak panah itu menunjukkan pada kita arah dari gerak benda yang kita berikan. And then number three, one or more forces always act on any object on earth. Is this true? Satu atau lebih gaya biasanya akan mengenai sebuah objek, ya, beberapa objek yang di bumi ini. Itu kita jawab setelah ini karena nanti ada contohnya di bawah, ya. And then the keywords analogy, analog itu ya seperti ya dianalogikan, balance itu seimbang, change direction, mengubah arah, maksudnya arah gaya mungkin ya, and then direction itu arahnya. So the direction of the force can be to the right, to the left, to the up, down, or maybe east, west, north, and so on. That is the direction. And then force itu gaya. Opposite, do you know? Anyone knows what is opposite?
Sebaliknya.
Ya, yeah. Opposite. The opposite of left is
right.
Very good. Slow down. Slow down. What is slow down? Anyone knows?
Pelan.
Melambat, ya. Yeah. Okay. Slow down. Speed up.
Cepat. Lebih cepat.
Bertambah. Speednya, kelajuannya. Kemudian unbalanced, tidak
seimbang.
What is balanced and unbalanced force? Ya, nanti kita tunjukkan, ya. Pak Ibu, saya juga kan just say that There are two, balance and unbalance. Nah, ini dia. Okay. So in this book there are a lot of text that we have to read, yeah, to understand the concept. Now we discuss about balanced or unbalanced. Okay, now the case, the stone on the ground. The stone on the ground. Okay, this is the diagram of the force. This one. The force diagram shows the balance forces acting on the rock. Ya, ini ada apa namanya? Gaya yang balance, seimbang, yang menunjukkan the force on the stone on the ground. Jadi gaya pada batu di atas tanah, ya, di atas lantai juga boleh. Oke. I need help from Mbak Dahayu.
Yes.
Please read this until this. Okay. Silakan. Please, Mbak Dahayu.
Look at the rock in the picture. The force of gravity is pulling it toward the center of the earth. This force is called its weight. The rock does not move toward the center of the earth because the ground is pushing up on the rock. This force is the contact force. These two forces are balanced. This means the forces are equal in size and opposite in direction. There could be more than two forces acting on the rock.
Okay. Okay, thank you so much. Now, from this text, we know that weight is one of force. Yeah, weight is one of force. Contact force also one of force. Now, based on the text, look at the rock in the picture. The force of gravity is pulling it toward to center of the earth. So weight actually influenced by the gravity. And if we read from the books, weight can be calculated by multiplication between mass, okay, mass, and then dot g. G is gravitation. M is mass. G is gravitation. So weight, the weight force is depend on the mass and gravitation. Different place will be different gravitation. So the weight of the same stone from or the same rock at the one place with the other place, it can be different if the gravity different. Jadi berat itu pada batu tertentu yang tetap itu beratnya bisa berubah jika we move from one place to the other place with different gravity. Jika batu itu kita pindah di tempat lain dengan gravitasi yang berbeda, maka daya beratnya akan berbeda. And then it towards the center of the earth. Jadi mengarahnya ke pusat bumi. Ya. This force is called its weight. Ini biasa disebut dengan weight atau berat. The rock does not move toward the center of the earth because the ground is pushing up on the rock. This force is the contact force. Jadi ketika batu, we put the rock on the ground, the rock not move to the center of the earth. Why? Because ada yang melawan, ya. Kenapa batu itu tidak terus kemudian ambles masuk ke dalam? Because there is a contact force. That the direction of the contact force is the opposite with the weight force. Yang contact force itu arah gayanya itu berlawanan. And the size of contact force and the weight is the same. Karena gaya kontak dan gaya berat itu sama, arahnya berbeda sehingga saling meniadakan. The resultant of the force is zero. Sehingga resultan gaya karena yang satu ke atas, misal the size for the examples 2 newtons and then the weight also 2 newtons. Maka 2 newton ke atas, 2 newton ke bawah. So the result is zero because 2 newtons minus 2 newtons equal with zero. If the force is zero, it means that there is no acceleration. There is no acceleration. Jadi kalau force-nya nol, maka tidak ada percepatan. Tidak ada percepatan. Yeah. Okay. Now we go to the main of this paragraph. I mean main thing, not main of the paragraph, tapi sesuatu yang sangat penting di sini. These two forces are balanced. Jadi forces ini balance antara kontak force, gaya kontak dan gaya berat. Kenapa kok balance? Karena ini this means the forces are equal in size and opposite in direction. Karena besar gayanya sama, but the direction in opposite. Tapi arahnya berlawanan. For the example, there is a rope, ada tali. And then Dahayu pull the rope to the right. Sarah Diana pull the rope to the left. Jadi Dahayu sama Sarah Diana tarik antali. Dahayu, the force of Dahayu is 2 newtons. The force of Sarah also 2 newtons. What happened after that? Enggak ada yang terjadi adalah diem talinya. Kan sama-sama nariknya 2 newton. We can say that as a balance force. Jadi itu bisa kita katakan gaya yang seimbang. There could be more than two forces acting on the rock. Ya ini ada kemudian ada bisa jadi lebih dari dua gaya. Ini gaya yang kita tahu kan weak and contact force. Nah itu bisa lebih dari itu ya ini. Oke, okay, I need help from Sarah Diana tadi sudah belum ya
Mbak Sarah? Iya belum.
Belum. Oke, okay, Mbak Sarah, please read from this until this.
Imagine the wind is blowing. The wind will push the rock from one side. Why does the rock not move sideways? The pushing force from the wind is balanced by friction between the rock and the ground. This force can be shown in a force diagram. In a force diagram, the arrows show the size and direction of each force. The longer the arrow, the bigger the force. So when you draw a force diagram with balance force, make sure the arrow are the same length and point in opposite direction.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Okay. I will not repeat for reading this text, but I will directly explain. Now, at this picture, yeah, in this picture, there will be about four. Okay, we can see four force, contact force to up and then down is weak force. But now we not discuss about that. We next, yeah. There is a wind to the left and friction. Of course, there is a friction to the right. The length of the arrow, panjang dari panah. So the size of force menunjukkan besarnya atau ukuran dari gaya. If we observe these forces, wind and friction force, the length of the arrow is the same. Ini panjang panahnya, ya, wind dan frictionnya itu panjangnya sama. It means that the size of friction and wind force is the same. Itu menunjukkan kedua gaya ini besarnya sama. And number two, based on this picture, the direction of the arrow in opposite condition. Jadi ini arahnya panah itu saling berlawanan gitu. Ya. Maka itu menunjukkan ini nanti balance. Ya. Nah, ini ya, length-nya sama berarti size-nya sama, and then opposite direction. The longer the arrow, the bigger the force. If the arrow of wind longer than the arrow of friction, it means that the size of wind force bigger than friction force. Okay. Saya tunjukkan kalau ini ya the arrow longer push from large vehicle, ini didorong dengan kendaraan besar ya seperti ini alat berat ke kiri itu kan lebih panjang, maka the size of push from large vehicle force bigger than friction force. So what happened? Kalau tekanannya dari kendaraan berat itu atau alat berat itu lebih besar daripada friction-nya, maka the stone or the rock move to the left. Maka batunya akan bergerak ke kiri. Kenapa? Karena gayanya yang ditimbulkan dari dorongan alat berat lebih gede daripada gaya gesek. Oke. Any questions? Do you understand? Okay, do you understand?
Yes.
Yes.
Very good. Any questions? Silakan kalau mau bertanya. Okay, kalau enggak, we go to the next. Slowing down. Anyone knows what is slowing down?
Melambat.
Okay. Tadi siapa yang ngomong melambat? Tadi yang laki-laki.
Saya.
Atta. Panggilannya siapa?
Rasya kan.
Rasya, not Atta.
Bukan.
Okay, Rasya, please read this. Slowing down.
Unbalanced or unequal force can also make moving objects slow down. A parachute makes a falling object slow down. When an object is falling quickly, the parachute causes a force of air resistance that is larger than the weight of the object. This force can be shown in a force diagram.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Okay. Before this picture, we have rock with contact force and weight. Ya, tadi kan ada batu, ada gaya kontak sama gaya berat ya. Besarnya kan sama tuh. Ya. Nah, sekarang we go to a case. A parachute makes a falling object slow down. Parachute akan membuat benda yang jatuh itu atau penerjun yang menuju ke bumi itu menjadi lebih pelan. When an object is falling quickly, the parachute causes a force of air resistance that is larger than the weight of the force. Jadi ketika objek itu atau orang penerjun itu jatuh, belum parasutnya belum terbuka, wes kan gitu. Ketika terbuka maka ada air resistant, hambatan udara, ya seperti di bawah ini. Tapi there are two, but this is this. Okay, there are two picture. This one I will give sign. This is number one. Okay, this is number two. Ismail.
Yes.
Please read text number one and number two.
The parachute first open, the force are unbalanced. This unbalanced force make the object slow down. When the object slow, the air resistance decrease, so the force become balanced again. Then the object falls at a constant speed. This force diagram shows the object falling at a constant speed.
Okay, thank you so much, Mas Ismail. There are two conditions when soldier jump from the plane using parachute. And the first time when the soldier opened the parachute is based on the concept number one, picture number one. When the parachute first open, ya, ketika parachute pertama kali di open dibuka, the forces are unbalanced. Jadi force, weak force sama air resistance-nya itu tidak balance, tidak sama. The proof is the length of the arrow is different. Ya kan? Panjang panahnya itu beda. Air resistance arrow longer than weak arrow. Ya kan? Jadi panjang. Jadi pertama kali anu apa dibuka kan kayak soldier-nya itu kayak berhenti, jet gitu kan. Habis itu ketika terbuka suddenly there is air resistance. Ya tiba-tiba ada hambatan udara. Kan terhambat tuh nggak langsung jatuh. Nah, setelah beberapa saat when the object slows, ya, ketika objeknya atau the soldier slows, jadi apa? Pelan-pelan the air resistance decreases. Kemudian gaya dari hambatan udaranya decrease atau berkurang sehingga di sini ditunjukkan with same size of arrow between air resistance and the wing. Nah, karena sama maka the speed ya mana nih? The speed is constant. Jadi kelajuannya itu menjadi konstan atau tetap. Jadi awalnya kan cepat tuh, seret langsung dibuka, dek, hampir berhenti terus pelan, lama-lama konstan. The speed is constant. Okay, can you imagine, Mas Ismail? Bisa membayangkan, Mas Ismail?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Now we discuss about changing direction. Okay. Mbak Afiza, please read.
Unbalanced force can also make object change directions. This tennis ball will change direction because of an unbalanced force. When the ball contacts the tennis racket, the ball pushes on the tennis racket to make the ball go back in the opposite direction. The hitting force must be larger than the force from the ball. This can be shown in a force diagram.
Thank you so much. Mbak Afiza. Mbak Afiza. Please tell me based on your opinion, ya, coba ceritakan berdasarkan pendapatmu the case of when the ball contacts the tennis racket and the ball pushed on the tennis racket. Ya, jadi ketika bola datang ya, the ball is coming and then we hit the ball using racket. And then the direction changes to be opposite. Coba ceritakan gimana prosesnya, Mbak Afiza. Bebas. Bebas, Mbak, silakan.
Force from the ball on the tennis racket.
Yes. Gimana?
The ball force. Mm-hmm. Tennis racket.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now you can tell in bahasa. Silakan pakai bahasa Indonesia. Coba ceritakan gimana prosesnya itu.
Sebentar.
Okay. Oke, okay. Mbak.
Bola mengenai raket.
Yes.
Lalu okay. Memantul.
Okay.
Lalu memantul.
Oke, okay, thank you so much, Mbak. Oke, okay. The process of changing direction. Jadi ini sebenarnya bahas tentang apa sih perubahan arah benda, arah geraknya, dan juga adanya interaksi dari gaya. Ketika when the ball is coming, ketika bola itu datang, there is force from the ball on the tennis racket. Jadi ada gaya datang raket. Just. Nah, we hitting force on the ball. Kita juga memberikan gaya, ya kita memukul, ya kan? Hitting force, gaya pukul, ya pukulan itu. Kan sebagai gaya kepada bola on the ball, and then the diagram is like this. Ini arrow-nya, the direction of hitting force, and then this is the direction of force from the ball on the tennis racket. Yeah, if we want to change the direction of the movement. Kalau kita ingin mengubah arah gerak dari bola, maka the length or the size of the hitting force must be bigger than force from the ball on the tennis racket. Jadi kalau misal hittingnya itu sama dengan di sini, misal ini panjangnya sama dengan ini, maka the ball cannot change the direction of the movement. Jadi bolanya ya berhenti. Jadi datang dek, wes berhenti, nggak balik lagi. Gitu ya, Mbak Afiza, you understand?
Ya, Ustaz.
Okay, good. Any questions? Any questions?
No.
Yes? No? Okay. Okay, now we go to the next. Mbak Nashwa. Assalamualaikum. Mbak Nashwa Aulia.
Waalaikumsalam.
Yes? Please yeah. Read this text.
Okay. Step 7 to square planets orbiting the sun due to the force of gravity. The force of gravity on a planet is a constant unable force. When an object moves in a circle, its direction is always changing. A constant unbalanced force needs to keep an object moving in a circle.
Thank you so much. Flashback, yeah. This remind us about stage 7, topic 3.3. This is about planets, yeah. Planets or solar system, direction of orbit planet. Jadi ini adalah direction arah dari orbit planet. The orbit planet is the track of the planet for move around the sun. Move around the sun. The force of gravity on a planet is a constant unbalanced force. Jadi apa? gaya gravitasi pada planet itu konstan. Constant unbounded force. When an object moves in a circle, its direction is always changing. A constant unbalanced force is needed to keep an object moving in a circle. Jadi ini membahas tentang ini ya. Apa namanya? Gaya. Jadi ada gaya tarik menarik antara bumi dengan matahari, sun ya. Sehingga terjadi atau bumi kita ini enggak jauh, enggak pergi dari matahari gitu ya. This is the summary. Okay, this is the question and then the examples 3.1. There are a lot of exercise, yeah. Speed, we have discussed about speed, yeah. Kita sudah bahas speed ya. Kemarin juga sudah ngitung ini ya. Oke. Okay. I will share the video, the teaching video describing movement. Yeah, movement. Tentang movement. Distance graph. Okay. I want to discuss this picture. Now, Mas Rafa.
Yeah.
Mas Rafa, there are four conditions of this diagram. Condition one, yeah. Condition one, condition two, condition three, and condition four.
Yeah.
Now the questions. What condition when the thing is at stationary or there is no movement? What condition? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh.
What? One. Are you sure?
Oh.
The condition that shows us
what
the thing is doesn't the thing doesn't move. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh.
Grafik yang menunjukkan kondisi benda ini tidak bergerak. Ayo,
Number two. Yes.
That's good answer. Why you choose number two? Why you choose number two?
Because not moving.
Because
not moving.
Not moving, because there is the distance is constant. Distance-nya itu kan tetap itu.
Ya.
Ya, jadi kalau di sini kemudian dia nggak gerak kan berarti distance-nya ya diem aja kan?
Ya.
Berarti ini there is no change of distance. If the distance is zero, kalau distance-nya zero. Ya berarti dia nggak bergerak kan?
Ya.
Iya. Distance-nya zero. Oke. Okay. Now I go to. Oke. Okay. Kalau yang C apa? Yang nomor satu apa?
Move
ya. Move. Kalau nomor tiga, move juga.
Ya.
Oh, kalau nomor empat?
Move,
tapi dia mungkin distance-nya semakin pendek gitu ya ini ya.
Ya.
Ya. Semakin mengecil. Ini ya. But there is a stationary address, yeah. Okay. Okay. From this picture, there will be some question, ya. Dari gambar ini bisa jadi banyak pertanyaan itu. Dari grafik ini distance and times, maka bisa ditanyakan seperti kecepatannya. Okay, we try this.
Right.
We try this, yeah. From okay, I give a sign from point A to point B. Okay. If you want to find out the speed, yeah, speed is equal with distance per time. Okay, khusus ya, special for A until B, yeah, the distance is from zero until this one. Ya, yeah, berapa ini? 2000. The unit is
200.
Hmm. 2 meters ya.
Meter per second.
2 meter and then
200.
The time is 200. What is the unit of the time?
Second.
Okay, ya. So we can reduce like this, zero with zero, and then this one, what? This is 10, ya. Yeah. So the speed is
10
meter per second.
Very good. 10 meter per
second.
Very good. Okay. Okay, do you understand with these questions? To answer these questions?
Yes.
Okay, easy?
Insyaallah.
Is it easy? Okay, insyaallah. Oh, ini sudah ada jawabannya. Ya. Yeah. Okay, very good. Ya, yeah. Work example ini. This is the real questions. Ya, yeah, ini ada real questions. Okay, I think enough. Yeah. Okay, I think the material is enough until here, but maybe we will discuss later with the next meeting. Okay? Because our lesson today with Kafaratul Majlis, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, asyhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa
atubu ilaik.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
See you.